So what makes the Moderna vaccine different from the already approved Pfizer vaccine?
That's actually one of the questions that you've asked, and medical reporter Liz Bonus will answer today. Liz joins us live now from St. Elizabeth in Edgewood. Hey, Liz.
Hey, good evening to you guys. We are here in Edgewood because they are giving the first doses of the Pfizer vaccine. They received 975 of those doses today. We've been able to kind of witness history here, which has been amazing. But many of you have asked, this vaccine that is expected to at least go to the committee on Thursday is the Moderna vaccine, and it has a lot of similarities, but a few differences, and here's why that is significant. The Moderna vaccine, just like Pfizer's, is what's called an mRNA vaccine. Both have been shown to be at least 90% effective at telling your body to fight off the coronavirus if you get exposed. Public health advisor Dr. Steve Fagans told me it helps in
reducing the severity, reducing how severe that is going to be.
According to the data, both are more than 90% effective at this after two doses, which both require. Both report no serious side effects with large combined number trials.
The phase 3 trials are well over 70,000 individuals. And so it's not like there was a shortcut. In fact, we've had many more eyes, even many more individuals on this vaccine. This may be not as long than any vaccine we've had kind of in history.
As for differences,
the one difference between the two products relates really to the cold chain requirements.
Pfizer vaccine needs to be kept at extremely cold temperatures, given within 6 hours after it's readied for use. Moderna just needs ordinary refrigeration and can be held up to 12 hours. This makes it easier to access for some rural areas and globally for those who may not have this kind of transportation and storage. I'm medical reporter Liz Bonus reporting.